to have nothing to say. Well, I'll find something someday. I thought that I was better off. I was wrong. I am where I don't belong. In a flash, I am gone to return.
Alright, what's up?
I just want to tell you, I've decided I don't want to do this thing, whatever it is, or was, with Adam anymore. I think the best thing to do would just be to end it. No strings, no formalities, so it's over.
Well, I'd be lying if I didn't think that that was a good idea. But, why are you telling me this? I mean, you never tell me anything like this unless there's a catch. So what's the catch? You want me to, what, go out and see what kind of guys want your phone number? Do you want me to see who wants to ask you to banquet? I mean, you never tell me anything like this unless you need help with a guy.
No, that's not it at all. I was thinking, as many times as Adam hasn't been there for me, you have been there for me. I need you.
Yeah, you usually need me to be your personal Kleenex. I guess you need me to be your personal matchmaker, too. Well, I just can't.
Sure, what's the matter? I just wanted to let you know how special you are to me. Why are you getting so angry?
Because, Mandy, I'm your friend. And that's all I'll ever be. I, too, am tired of being strung along. I'm tired of it. I mean, I'll always be second best because I'm such a good friend. You know, as you so aptly put it, we should just end things right now. No strings, no formalities, just... I'll see you around.
Hey. Get up, man. You've been laying in that bed all week.
That's not true. You got up a couple of times to use the restroom.
Yeah, too bad you didn't make a stop by the shower at all. Okay, man, what is it? What happened?
It's never going to change, is it?
What?
With Mandy. I talked to her Monday after class. Said that she was cutting the cord with Adam. Then she gave me the "you're a great friend" spiel again.
What exactly did she say?
Well, she told me about how I've always been there for her when Adam hadn't, and how much of a good friend I was to her. You know, regulatory friend card.
Drew, I love you, man, so I don't want you to take this the wrong way or anything, but you're an idiot.
What is that, another candy bar analogy?
No, it's a stupid person. Let me explain. Mandy was not trying to give you the shaft, and she wasn't trying to pull the friend card on you. She was trying to tell you, in no uncertain terms, that she has officially reciprocated the feelings which you have possessed for so long. She likes you?
Oh, dude. I totally missed that one. Oh, no.
What?
I might have sort of kindly totally broke it off with her.
What?
Well, I couldn't handle being friends with her anymore, so I told her that I didn't want to see her.
You are an idiot.
Oh, what do I do?
Well, you find her and tell her how much of an idiot you are and apologize, duh.
Right.
Drew.
What?
You might want to take a shower first. Just a suggestion.
Right.
She likes me! Woo! She likes me! She really likes me!
I want you.
matter, Julie?
I gotta tell you something.
Okay, what is it?
All right, the other day, when I told you that I didn't want to see you anymore, that couldn't be further from the truth.
Okay, what is the truth?
All right, the truth is that I care about you way too much. I care about you too much to see you run after Adam. I care about you too much to be with you every day and not be able to tell you how I feel. The truth is that I need you, Mandy. And that sometimes that when I'm not with you, I feel like I'm missing something, something great. If you want me to just shut up now and walk away, it's too well. Wow, I was missing something great. So, what does this mean?
It means we're not friends anymore.
I think I can deal with that.
Me too.
I've been searching a long time. Someone exactly like you. I've been traveling all around the world, waiting for you to come through. Someone like you make it all worthwhile. Someone like you keep me satisfied. Someone exactly like you. Traveling a hard road.